गांधी नवोदय विद्यालय चनलिया अल्मोड़ा के सभी एनसीसी कैडेट्स एवं पूरा नवोदय परिवार आपका हार्दिक स्वागत करता है। माँ शारदे को मेरा सत्कार नमन। आदरणीय प्रधानाचार्य महोदय और आज के मुख्य अतिथि महोदय कमांडेंट श्री अनिल बोस जी का हम नवोदय परिवार में हार्दिक स्वागत करते हैं। ऐसी अपेक्षा करते हैं कि वे हम बच्चों का मार्गदर्शन करते रहे ताकि हम भविष्य में देश सेवा का कार्य कर सके। अब मैं एनसीसी कैडेट हर्षिता एनसीसी के इतिहास के बारे में कुछ शब्द कहना चाहूंगी। एनसीसी का गठन भारत की आजादी के एक वर्ष के पश्चात 16 अप्रैल को किया गया था। इसका गठन भारत में मौजूद भारतीय एक्ट 1917 के अंतर्गत किया गया था। एनसीसी का गठन उस वक्त सेना में सैनिकों की कमी के कारण किया गया था।
एनसीसी कमांडेंट कर्नल मिस्टर अनिल बोस सर एंड अदर सर फॉर लाइट एंड लैंप स्टार्ट द प्रोग्राम्स।
Thank you. Can you hear me at the back?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Firstly, I would like to thank the principal, all the staff, my, you know, and all the cadets and the students as well for having organized this get together. It was a wonderful song you have presented. And I am Colonel Anil Bose. I am the CEO of 77 NCC Battalion, Almora. This is my first exposure to NCC. I came here as the Adam officer of 77 after the commanding officer went on superannuation in Feb. I took over the battalion. There were 33 institutions as part of 77 NCC battalion. I visited 32. Only one school was left, that was this. Due to corona pandemic, the school was not opened last year, because of which I could not visit here. So I went to Dorat, that's it. Okay. Same, because of this COVID, there was no offline training. Day cadre was conducted for the HD cadets. No offline training was conducted to the JD. And this time, after the enrollment of the inter-colleges, which will scheduled to be completed by 27th of this month. From 1st October, we will be carrying with the online training for the cadets. Now coming on to my achievements. I had only one aim in my life, that is to join the army. My parents wanted me to become a doctor or an engineer. I have appeared for both the entrance exam. I got selected for engineering. I think I got civil engineering. I left it and continued with my normal graduation. And I was not aware of NDA at that time when I completed my plus two. I came to be aware after completing 12th when I joined graduation. I started preparing for CDS since then only. After graduation, I did 2 years of law also. Meanwhile, I cleared CDS and CDS interview, after which I got selected to the IIM. CDS interview is a 4-day procedure. You are assessed by 3 different people. Same, all SSB interviews. It's 4-day procedure. For NDA also it is the same. First is the screening out. Around 75% of the students or candidates will be screened out on the first day after the basic aptitude test. Thereafter, it will be followed by the psychological test, which will be assessed by a psychologist. There is a word assessment test, picture test. Then there will be an interview by the board president or the deputy president of the board. And the third person who will assess you is the group testing officer. He will assess you individually in the various performance, in the various group tasks. You will be made to participate in group discussion, group planning, obstacles and lecture aids. And finally the interview, followed by the medicals. You have to clear the medicals. And if you make it in the final merit, you will be selected. So this is how I got selected. When I boarded the train from my hometown, that from Kerala, I had viral fever. Those days the trains were not that fast. My SSB was in Bhopal. 21 SSB. I had severe viral fever when I boarded the train from Kochi. And some students were going to Gorakhpur. It was Cochin Gorakhpur train. There were 4 students who boarded the train from Coimbatore. They saw my condition and they gave me some medicines and I took that medicine. I became alright after 2 days. When I landed in Bhopal on the 4th day, I never imagined I could perform well in the SSB interview. But I got selected. it is nothing. It is just what I realize is you have to be genuine. You have to be yourself. Don't try to imitate anyone. Don't try to impress anyone. Be yourself and express yourself. What I have seen in Almora, in Uttarakhand, basically, our cadets, there is no dearth of talent, which you already witnessed. Cultural, be it physical activities, they are very good. But one grey area I found was their expression, sense of expressions, expressive skills. When they go for such interviews, students from Delhi and all, they may be lower in merit than our cadets, academically, but they make it in the interview because their expressive skills are better. They are able to perform better in their interview because of their expressive skills. So my point is that you must develop this habit of reading, inculcate reading habit, and develop an analytical mindset. What is good, what is bad, you should analyze and express your opinion. You should have your own individual opinion. The aim of education is to identify, differentiate between the good and the bad. If you are not able to do that, there is no point in having education. Not just scoring marks in the exams. Okay. After getting commissioned to Madras Regiment, I got posted to various places all over India. Most of the time I was in Northeast, about 75% of my tenure was in Northeast. I had one tenure in UN mission, that is in Congo, that was in 2007. Before that I was in Pithoragarh. And right now I am coming from Calcutta. I was in the Eastern Headquarters, Eastern Command. From there I got posted to NCC. This is my first exposure in NCC. It is totally different from what I have been going through all this throughout my service. And it was nice to interact with various cadets, especially talented cadets. And to see that there, I am very happy to see that most of them are very motivated to join the armed forces, especially in Uttarakhand. This is the main interest which I found in most of the cadets. For which B certificate as well as the C certificate. This is the JD, you will get A certificate. B certificate and C certificate will help you. My point is that you must do well in whatever you are doing. You must try to be proficient in whatever you are doing. The moment you clear your certificate, you get some grading A, B or C, whatever it is. Now going to the next level, B cadet, going to B or going to C. When you go for the selection, they will see your certificate, your grading. If you have got a good grade, the first impression is created there. You will be looked by the interviewing officer or the selector at that level. Next, you must express your capabilities. If you don't express, the person won't be able to assess you. You must tell what are your good qualities, what are your strengths. You must be able to express it. For that, you got to know yourself. It is very easy to say, to introduce. Self-introduction, it is very, looks very easy. But when you introduce yourself, you must create, generate an interest in the interviewing officer or interviewing the person who is selecting you, to create an interest in him or her to know more about you. My interview in SSB took 40 minutes. You should have hobbies, interests, games and sports. You must have some interest in games and sports, hobbies. You must be able to express it. My hobby that time was stamp collection. People will laugh at it because nobody writes letters these days. Everything is online. I used to collect stamps. So the first question was, what is the other name for stamp collection? I told it is flipping. So what is so good about stamp collection? What are the advantages? What did you gain from stamp collection? So I have to make it colorful. I told him, whatever it is, I told him stamp collection. You see, I'm sitting down south in Kerala. I never had any opportunity to see anywhere else other than my hometown. But by developing this hobby, I was able to collect stamps from more than 100 countries. These stamps each country has many stamps from each various countries. I could know what their currency is, what their capital is, what is their language, what are the important events, important personalities, what are the flora, fauna, historical importance. Everything we can see from those stamps. Those days there was no internet, but still we were able to learn about various countries just by collecting stamps. This is one of the things. So whatever hobbies and interests you are having, you should be able to express it in a way that the interviewing officer should be able to generate some interest to know more about it. Once, then he asked me what which discipline have you graduated. I told him, science graduate, chemistry. Okay, tell me about the economic condition of India. No connection with science. So my point is, if you are, one must have a common general knowledge about what other field knows. You must develop this habit of reading newspaper, especially the editorial part, letters to the editors. You read that, you will be able to analyze each news which is coming in the newspaper or in the news. Those days we had only one magazine, one or two magazines, they had competitions, and these days there are many. And the media coverage is more. You got wide variety of access to what is happening around. National news, be it national, international, whatever it is. So you must keep yourself abreast with what is happening around you. And analyze it. Develop this habit right from now onwards. Every day you must read at least one page of a newspaper. How many of you read newspapers? Or see the news? Listen to BBC? You must listen to BBC. Or a national news, Doordarshan news, good enough. And listen to the news, listen to the various discussions which is happening. That is how you can develop your analytical thinking. Next is the expressive skills. You must read, your vocabulary increases, improves. You will be able to express things better. And the best way to develop this expressive skill, about, take the case of self-introduction. You stand in front of the mirror and speak in front of the mirror. If possible, record it and listen to it yourself. You yourself will be able to understand what are the drawbacks. You improve it. You don't need any guidance. You can improve on your own. Those days, we never had any guidance. It's on self-interest. That's it. Any student, anyone, any person who has the will to learn can learn. If you lack the will, then nobody can help you. The main thing is you must have the will to learn new things every day. And never be scared of anything. Just understand. The fear will go away. Try to understand things. That is the only way to remove the fear from your mind. The fear of unknown. Try to understand things. The fear will go. That is why people say knowledge is power. Anything else you want to know about me? All of you are good physically. Everyone is good. Generally, all the cadets are good physically, culturally. Only thing is lacking is the expressive skills.
छोटा क्वेश्चन पूछो कुछ पूछना है सर से तो आपको आर्मी के बारे में एनसीसी के बारे में.
The various avenues to join army or defence forces. NDA, CDS, NCC entry scheme is there. If nothing is available, you do law. There is a acute shortage of lawyers in the army. You do your LLB, you can get, you go through the SSB interview and get selected. And the age limit is 27, I think. And the women now, they are got opportunity to join NDA or as well. Anything else? Thank you.
NCC Cadet Nisha, respected principal sir, NCC Commander Mr. Anil Bose sir, teacher, staff members, and all my elder and younger brothers and sisters and dear classmates. provided me a very good chance that I could come upon stage and say something about today's day. NCC, National Cadet Corps. The NCC in India was formed through National Cadet Corps Act of 1948. It can be traced back to the University Corps, which was created under the Indian Defence Act 1917 with the objective to make up for the shortage in the army. May this sir in his course visit no land more free, more happy, more lovely than this our country. Organization which is regulated under the Ministry of Defence. It acts as the body to provide the basic military training that inculcate the feeling of commandership, honesty, and above all the patriotism. Patriotism consists not in waving the flag, but In striving that our country shall be righteous as well as strong. It comes into force in 1948 with the view to impart the rudimentary skills and training in handling of weapons of different types and make them physically tough such that they could face the hardship easily. Freedom lies in being bold. NCC training is given to students in age group of 13 to 26 in the school and college. It is given in Army Naval and Air Force stream depending upon the aptitude of students. This nation will remain the land of the free, only so long as it is the home of the brave, Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Honorable NCC Commandant General Ronnie Bose sir, principal sir, teachers, and all my brothers and sisters. First of all, a warm welcome to all of you in this program. I am Kadi Khatun in front of you for a speech. First of all, I want to tell you something about NCC. NCC, the National Cadet Corps, is the Indian Military Cadet Corps, which is headquartered in New Delhi. It is open to school and colleges, students on voluntary basis. The National Cadet Corps in India is a voluntary organization secured cadets from high school, colleges, universities all over the India. It came into force in 1948 with a view to impart the rudimentary skills and training in handling of weapons of different types and make them physically tough, such that they could face the hardship easily. NCC training is given to students in age group of 13 to 26 in school and college. It is given in Army, Naval, Air Force, depending upon the aptitude of students. Now, I want to share some of my personal experience in NCC. I am Kadet Atul. My personal motivation to join the NCC was the awesome sight of many Republic Day Parade, Independence Day Parade, and the inspiring uniform of NCC. NCC was a turning point in my life. It changed me from a common person. It taught me the quality of leadership, time management, stress management, teamwork, selflessness, discipline, and still I am learning from it. After selected in NCC, our NCC trainer taught me many new things and he made all NCC classes interesting and motivating. He is very motivating for me and also my inspiration. The life of an NCC cadet is one of the best experiences I have. It taught how to live life. And so, I was to be an officer in Indian Armed Forces. We cadet live life of an officer without being part of any prominent Indian military training institutes like Indian Army. This year, we have NCC camp, but due to the pandemic situation, we could not be the part of it. But still hoping to go out and learn more things and be the best NCC cadet and make my teachers, family members and friends be proud. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Our chief guest, Commandant Mr. Anil Bose. Dear students,
first type of exams in different situation. Problems are having every individual, but every person who have self-confidence, scholarship achievement and other good qualities, having faced their goals and get their target easily. So we all are very very thankful to CEO sir. So it is very good and just you know, we all are gathered here after 1.5 years due to COVID pandemic disease. So it is the first chance we all are gathered in this room. So we all are very happy, and this function NCC 77 UK Battalion Almora at present RGNP Cholali Almora, this is very good chance to learn every good personality. So we all are living this Uttarakhand who have gives different types of leaders, soldiers and brave soldiers. Maximum soldiers have got Paramveer Chakra either in forces and different types of award they got. So this Uttarakhand is a state in all over India who has gives I think maximum number of soldiers. They will also give a position in this state. So our feeling, our ambition to all our children to achieve such type of position, and this is intellectual mass, and here all types of students belonging to different blocks. So hope all of you that you will inspire such type of programs and give their 100% potential to make your future very bright and give you a position in this state, Uttarakhand. So that is really you studied such type of Navoday campus. So all we are go through such type of qualities like self-confidence. Our case masters have shared you such type of qualities. So our colonel sir also ask you to any questions, any problems, who students also take interest in armed force. So it is very very good occasion to choose such type of armed forces and NCC, the route. NCC either A, B, C certificates also gives you to such type of direction, and we all hope all of our NCC candidates and other students to get such type of achievement and make your future bright. Thank you.
Especially
have महोदय, आचार्य महोदय, बच्चे शिक्षकों, प्यारे बच्चों, आज हम बहुत दिनों बाद शायद एक डेढ़ साल बाद मिले हैं, तो बच्चों में काफी जोश था और इसके जो ये जो हमारा मिलने का जो ओकेजन है, हम सीओ सर के बड़े आभारी हैं, उन्होंने हमको मिलने का ऐसा मौका दिया कि बहुत दिनों बाद हम यहाँ पर सब लोग साथ बैठे हुए हैं, क्योंकि दो साल के पश्चात बच्चों से हमारी मुलाकात हो रही है बहुत बच्चों के नाम भी मैं भूल गया हूँ, तो सिक्स में जो आए थे वो शायद उसके बाद एट्थ में पहुंच गए, तो कभी कभी मैं कंफ्यूजन भी होता है कि नहीं तुम एट्थ में आ गए हो, तुम तो सिक्स में आए थे, तो ऐसा मौका आज हमको एनसीसी ने दिया है तो हम हमारी बहुत बहुत। और बच्चों मैं आपको बताना चाहता हूँ एनसीसी के बारे में थोड़ा सा। एनसीसी क्या है? हमारे अंदर चरित्र निर्माण और एकता और अनुशासन ये बढ़ाने का, इसको हमारे जो करैक्टर निर्माण में बड़ा योगदान दे रहा है, देश की एकता को अखंडता को बनाए रखने में एनसीसी जो है बहुत बड़ा योगदान है। आप देखते होंगे सब लोग मिलकर काम कर रहे हैं इसमें, और ये जो मिलकर कर रहे हैं हमने बहुत ही शॉर्ट समय में इसको सब किया है, तो ये सब बच्चों के सहयोग से भी हो रहा है। तो बच्चों ये जो आपका जो ए सर्टिफिकेट का जो एसबीओ साहब आए हैं, कुछ बच्चों का सिलेक्शन करेंगे, देखते हैं क्या जो भी करना है उनका प्रोसीजर अलाउ करेंगे, तो जो आपको अगर ए सर्टिफिकेट के लिए आप क्वालिफाइड होते हैं, एडमिशन आपका होता है, तो 2% मार्क्स आपको मिलते हैं, उसके बाद जब ए कर लेंगे आपको फिर बी के लिए आप अप्लाई करेंगे, हमारे यहाँ बी के लिए नहीं यहाँ पर मान्यता, तो अगर अगर भविष्य में होगी तो हम बी कराएंगे, फिर उसके बाद सी सर्टिफिकेट होता है, यूनिवर्सिटी लेवल पर सी सर्टिफिकेट करते हैं तो उसको 5% मार्क्स मिलते हैं, 2%, 3% और 5% मार्क्स आपको मिलते हैं। तो इसका फायदा यह है कि आप अगर जैसे एनडीए के एग्जाम में कभी आगे उसको एंट्रेंस एग्जाम देते हैं और क्वालिफाइड कर जाते हैं, और मेडिकल में आपका अगर थोड़ी बहुत कोई कमी है, मेजर फॉल्ट नहीं है आपके बॉडी में, ठीक है, तो आप क्या है एनडीए के लिए सिलेक्ट हो सकते हैं। तो ये जो आपको समय जो 2% है, 3% है और 5% है, यानी 10 से 15 नंबर आपको एक्स्ट्रा जो मिलेंगे वो आपके काम आएंगे, ठीक है। तो जो मेजर फॉल्ट में आता है आपके दोनों जो पैर के घुटने हैं मिलने नहीं चाहिए, ठीक है, और आपके दांत सही होने चाहिए, आंखें आपकी सही होनी चाहिए, ये मेजर फॉल्ट में आते हैं, ये चीजें आपकी नहीं होनी चाहिए, तो आप ये जो आप एनसीसी कर रहे हो इसका फायदा उस समय मिलेगा, ठीक है। तो इसका बड़ा इम्पोर्टेंस है, तो आप इसको अच्छे ढंग से करेंगे, यहाँ से सीख के जाएंगे, जब ये सब करके जाएंगे तो फिर आपको बड़ा फायदा मिलेगा, ठीक है। तो अंत में मैं प्राचार्य महोदय से ऐसा अपेक्षा करूंगा कि वो समाप्ति घोषणा करेंगे, और ठीक है सर, धन्यवाद।
विजवल सर यही थे अभी सर,
नहीं हवस नहीं किसी को, कोई वश नहीं, क्या जिंदगी है वो करो बमार दो, मौत अंत है नहीं तो मौत से भी क्यों डरे, ये जाके आसमान में।